A new Marine One is on its way. Marine One denotes a helicopter operated by Marine Helicopter Squadron One, intended to carry the U.S. President. More than 800 U.S. Marines are involved in the operation of the Marine One fleet. These helicopters are called the White Tops because of their green and white paint scheme. The VH-92A, intended to be the next Marine One, has taken to the air for the first time. The VH-92A is adapted from the Sikorsky S-92 Helibus. The helicopter will replace both the venerable VH-3D and VH-60N helicopters currently working in the role of Marine One. The helicopter is expected to reach initial operating capability in 2020. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes the upcoming Marine One that will fly the U.S. President. Let's get started. The replacement program for the presidential helicopter is going on for a long time, actually since the time of the Bush administration. Sikorsky S-92 and the US-101 were in the final competition. US-101 was based in Augusta Westland Trimotored EH-101. The program management and systems integration were planned to be done by Lockheed Martin, whereas assembling was to be executed by Bell Textron. US-101 won the contract, beating the S-92. US-101 was renamed the VH-71 Kestrel. The VH-71 was much bigger than both the aircraft it was supposed to replace and also much more complex than the S-92. The program saw a massive cost increment. The unit cost of each of the 23 helicopters went up to an average of $400 million per chopper. Viewers may note that this is even more than the F-22 Raptor, the most potent fighter jet in the world. President Obama, during a televised White House meeting, had said, "The helicopter I have seems fine to me." US-101 was canceled in 2009. After the failure of US-101, S-92 was chosen for Marine One role in 2014, ending the long-drawn confusion. Under this new VH-92 program, the plan is that by 2023, there will be 23 customized aircraft to be delivered. This includes 17 production helicopters, 4 for training and 2 for testing. They will be replacing both the VH-3D and VH-60 in the Marine One role. The Marine Corps is to purchase these 17 production aircraft over the course of 3 years, between fiscal years 2019 and 2021. The VH-92A fleet that's expected to enter service in 2020. The helicopter requires 2 crew to navigate, pilot and co-pilot. S-92 has a capacity to accommodate 19 passengers, but in the Marine One role, the craft will see a very specific interior setup to meet the tactical requirements meant for the U.S. President. The S-92 is powered by 2 General Electric CT-7-8A turboshaft, each producing 2,520 horsepower. The engines are able to deliver enough power to enable a maximum speed of 165 knots, or 190 miles per hour, or 306 kilometers per hour. S-92 has a range of 539 nautical miles, or 999 kilometers, and a service ceiling of 14,000 feet, or 4,270 meters. VH-92 will have many upgrades over the baseline S-92. This includes increased situational awareness with an additional multifunctional display. S-92 comes with 4 MFD, 2 each for the pilot and co-pilot, whereas VH-92 will have 5 with 1 added in the center. Viewer may note that there will be many other technical upgrades which will be kept classified to keep the actual capability of Marine One a secret.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.